on camera.
Cut!
Okay, the biggest smackdown of 1988 was between Tiffany and Debbie Gibson for the title Queen of Pop. Shake your love. I just can't shake
your love. If you think Britney and Christina Aguilera have got a feud going on now, Debbie Gibson and Tiffany were the 80s answer.
Forget Britney, do you know what I mean? It was all about Debbie Gibson and Tiffany.
Who's the best, Debbie Gibson or Tiffany? I would have liked to see them fight in a sort of 80s way with lots of lace and fingerless leather gloves.
God, that's pretty wild. That's like a lot of people's wildest dream.
Sixteen-year-old Tiffany was the first to make it big in Britain.
Children behave. That's what they say when we're together. And watch how you play.
I used to really like Tiffany, actually. Oh, God, what was that song? It was,
And we're running just as fast as we can. Trying to get away into the night. And then you put your arms around me and I stumble to the ground. And then you say,
I think we're alone now.
There doesn't seem to be anyone around.
I think we're alone now, feeling the dirt on the other side.
Tiffany was, and this is no offence to Tiffany, it's an offensive term, but she was a mall rat, wasn't she? She was what the Americans call a mall rat. She was the kind of kid, valley girl kid, you'd see hanging around going, oh my God, at the shopping mall.
I love Tiffany. She became successful because she sang in shopping centres. Brilliant.
I can't imagine doing that in Bolton Arndale Centre.
Which seems such a cheap thing to do, doesn't it? So naff.
The Bullring Shopping Centre had never seen anything quite like it. Police and security officers were taken by surprise when more than 4,000 fans crowded in to see Tiffany, the 16-year-old star whose first single went to the top of the American charts, beating Madonna, Michael Jackson and Bruce Springsteen for the number one slot.
It's really good publicity, you know, because that encouraged people to buy records and everything. It's just really good. It's a good thing to do.
I was really excited. And I think it went really well, and the fans were really nice. I enjoyed it.
Started your career with two number one singles in America.
And now she's gone number one here. She is the lady who makes Madonna look like your granny. Tiffany!
I think we're alone. You and me. All
there was this bit in the middle. And she had this dance where she just, and the foot would go out and the hand would come across. And all the girls were doing the Tiffany dance.
She was doing all that.
No, I don't remember that.
I don't remember that, but I do remember her going on Top of the Pops in some huge jumper. I just remember, I can't remember, was it mohair or something? It's just some enormous jumper that she was wearing, and I just thought, she must be so hot.
But if Tiffany was the mall queen,
whoa, Debbie Gibson looked like the prom queen.
Debbie Gibson was kind of your sweet girl next door. She was the original Britney without all the sexy outfits.
If you compare the Britney Spears of today and the Debbie Gibson of 88, you have two totally different people. A sexy young thing, you have a girl who was truly a teenager.
It's always a stylist's dream to take a little girl and make them look like jailbait. Unlike the teenagers of today,
I did not have a body. I did not have a waistline to show off.
She would write 8, 10, 12 songs every day. One night I woke up in the middle of the night and I found Deborah out of her bed and I didn't see her in the room. And I get up and I look around and where is she but in the bathroom, sitting in the tub with her comforter, her blanket in the tub. So she made herself a nice little comfy spot with a candle burning and she was writing music. She was writing songs.
Sick of hearing obscene references to Shake Your Love, because I wrote it as, you know, I can't shake my love for you, I can't get rid of this feeling.
Shake your love, I just can't shake your love.
Shake your love,
I just can't shake your love.
All through my teenage years and to date, radio personalities are always saying, you know, I was shaking my love to one of your songs the other day, and I don't know, oh, please, like I haven't heard that one before.
Hello, I am
Laura,
and she is
Debbie Gibson,
and we are here to talk about
your career.
In 1988, I became the youngest artist in music history to write, perform, and produce a number one hit, which that record hasn't been broken to date, which amazes me, because I'm waiting for one of these like handsome kids to come along or something, you know.
Good, there we go.
I now meet 17 and 18 year old girls and think, I cannot believe, you know, the chutzpah I had at that age. I mean, I look at them and I think that's insane that I was calling the shots at that age.
Debbie and Tiffany burnt real bright for a year. I'm talking about 4 U.S. number ones and 5 top 10 hits in the U.K. But if they had a problem with each other, they weren't saying.
We got burnt out on each other with people expecting there to be something, you know, between the two of us. And I was always being asked questions about her and, you know, kind of answering not only for myself, but her.
All the rivalries that press kind of created were just that. They were fabricated rivalries. In fact, Tiffany's in the speed dial on my cell phone. It's like a lot of people's wildest dream is to be on a concert stage and to have people emulating you and singing words that you wrote, melodies that you wrote. And, you know, I can kind of say forever and ever, I have that. That happened for me.